Welcome to my channel. Today's topic is journal entry. Let's see how to pass the journal entry for charity given. Example, a company ABC Private Limited gave goods to a charity which cost them ₹20,000. Pass journal entry for charity. The headings should be written as particulars, debit, credit, rupees. Now, charity given is always an expense, so charity account is debited. According to the nominal account rule, debit all expenses and losses. So charity account is debited. Then, what is happening? Goods are given as charity. So there is a decrease in purchase of goods. So purchase account should be credited. Decrease in goods. So it is credited. For goods given as charity, we can use the term as purchases. So the entry is charity account debtor to purchases account. Okay, let's write the journal entry for charity given. Charity account debtor to purchases. To purchases account. Amount, sorry, narration, being goods given as charity. Amount is ₹20,000. When goods are distributed as free samples, it is like an advertisement. So whenever free samples are given, it is like an advertisement. We already know that advertisement is an expense. So we have to debit advertisement account and credit purchases because goods are given as free samples. So there is decrease in goods, that is decrease in purchases. So the entry is advertisement account debtor to purchases account. Narration, being goods given as free samples. Okay, now let's find the answer for these questions. Goods given as charity are dash for the business. Option A, sale. Option B, income. Option C, expense. So goods, when goods are given as charity, it is an expense for us. We already discussed in journal entry, isn't it? So option A and B is ruled out and option C, that is expense, is the correct answer. So we have to write goods given as charity or expense for the business. Advertisement account is to record the journal entry for goods distributed as free samples. Option A, debited. Option B, credited. Option C, ignored. We already discussed in preparing the journal for charity. Advertisement is an expense, isn't it? So we have to debit advertisement account. We already know that expenses are debited according to the nominal account rule, debit all expenses and losses. So we have to write advertisement account is debited. ऑप्शन ए इज द आंसर. Advertisement account is debited to record the journal entry for goods distributed as free samples. Next one, goods given as free samples are for the business. Option A, fictitious asset. Option B, expense. Option C, sale. So what is the answer for this? Goods are given as free samples, so it is like an expense. Expense for the business, because we already know that it is like an advertisement, isn't it? Advertisement is an expense. So we have to write the answer as expense. Goods given as free samples are expense for the business. Okay, now let's see this problem. First example for discount allowed. Cash received for goods sold to ABC Private Limited worth 50,000 along with a 10% discount. So what is the journal entry for this discount allowed? So the entry will be cash account debtor. Why we are debiting cash? Because when we allow discount, okay, the amount gets reduced, but we are receiving cash. So debit what comes in? Cash is coming in. So we have to debit cash account. So the entry is cash account debtor. Cash received for rupees 50,000 goods sold. 50,000 worth of goods sold, isn't it? And they have allowed us discount for 10%. Now, what is the discount on this 50,000? 5,000 is the discount, isn't it? Okay, what is 10% discount on rupees 50,000? So, 50,000 into 10 by 100. 5,000 rupees, isn't it? This is discount allowed. Remember that when we allow discount to our customers, what happens? It is a loss for us, isn't it? That's why discount allowed is debited. As per the nominal account rule, debit all expenses and losses. So the entry is cash account debtor. Entry is cash account debtor. How much cash we are receiving? Let's see. First we'll write discount allowed account debtor to ABC Private Limited. Account. Okay. Now we are allowing discount of rupees 5,000. Okay. How much cash we should receive from ABC? 50,000, isn't it? But we are receiving only 45,000 rupees. See, we have sold goods to the extent of rupees 50,000. We are allowing discount of rupees 5,000. So now we are receiving cash of rupees 45,000. Debit what comes in? Cash. Cash is coming in. So we are debiting cash account. Discount allowed is a loss. So we are debiting discount allowed as per the nominal account rule. Debit all expenses and losses. And ABC Private Limited account is credited. Why ABC Private Limited account is credited? Because there is decrease in sundry debtors. Okay. So, ABC Private Limited account is credited. Narration being discount allowed on goods sold. Understood. We already know that sundry debtors is like an asset. But in this transaction, there is a decrease in sundry debtors. That's why ABC Private Limited account is credited. Entry is cash account debtor 45,000, discount allowed upon debtor 5,000, to ABC Private Limited account 50,000. The next question is received 5,000 rupees in full and final settlement. Underline the word final settlement. Final settlement of their account rupees 10,000 from ABC Private Limited. So what do you understand? So for this 10,000 rupees, we are receiving only 5,000 rupees. How we came to know that we are receiving only 5,000 rupees? Because they have clearly mentioned that 5,000 rupees in full and final settlement of 10,000. So we have to receive 10,000 rupees, but we have received rupees 5,000 as the final settlement. That means rupees 5,000 is discount allowed. Okay. So the entry is cash account debtor. Discount allowed account debtor. Then to ABC Private Limited account. Okay. So now we are receiving 5,000 rupees. Receipt 5,000 rupees. We are receiving 5,000 rupees for this 10,000 rupees. 10,000 rupees. So what is the remaining balance? 10,000 minus 5,000? 5,000. So this 5,000 is discount allowed. So here ABC Private Limited is credited because it is a decrease in sundry debtors. So decrease in asset will be credited. Narration B. Discount allowed to ABC Private Limited. Okay, let's discuss this question now. Charity account is debited, credited, ignored. Which is the correct answer? We already know that charity account is debited. It is like an expense. So according to the nominal account rule, debit all expenses and losses. That's why charity account is debited. So the right answer is option A. Thanks for watching. Please do like, share and subscribe.